to refer you, Mr. Chairman, to the table that I have presented, which we are going to put together in the report, and I hope honorable senators, through the chair, have that table. And that table does some analysis that are really, really critical to us. It's looking at the 2019 population, and it's looking at the allocation using the current formula. And Mr. Chair, if you go to number 22, which is Kiambu, you realize that with a population of 2.4 million, with an allocation of about 9.357, or just about 9.4, our per capita allocation is 3,870. If you look across, if you go up, we have the lowest per capita allocation. And that is a very, very important indicator, Mr. Chair. Kiambu has the lowest per capita allocation. I don't want to talk to other about other counties, but you go up there, you see a county with a 24,000 per capita allocation, 14,000, and so we have the lowest. So what we've done is we said, suppose we keep the formula as it is, and now we compute and say what would be our allocation. Our allocation would increase slightly by 1,000 to 4.8. But what it does is that it is much more even. There are some still with over 10,000, but it's much more even. It doesn't mean that all of us should be poor so that we are happy. Would all of us want to be rich? But through the proposals that we are putting forward, we would move to the level of 5,000, another 200 or so. And as you can see, it provides some level of equity. And therefore, the main problem with the existing formulas has been that they have been rad area based, and being a disadvantage with that area, then that has been one of our problems.
The allocation of the funds should just be given according to the population of each and every county, rather than on the landmass or the area that each and every county covers. We can see just that the county that was before Ms. Kiambu County, we may share the proposal that they had on the fact that they have a lot of population in their own county, and they would wish to be given more resources because they have a lot of population to cover.
Once the increase in health and water, we'll really be able to translate to increase in other indicators, because those are basically some of the fundamental or basic requirements in those particular regions.